sanctuary and bless the Lord. God, we thank you. We praise you. We come bringing you the sacrifices of praise, lifting you up and magnifying you, God. For you are high above. You are above every problem, every circumstance. And God, we make you big today. In the name of Jesus, God, we give you a down payment of praise for everything that you are doing for us right now, God. Thank you that you're working everything out for our good. Thank you that you're lifting up the hung down head, God. Thank you for the garments of praise that you are giving unto us to fight the spirit of heaviness, God. In the name of Jesus, fill this place with your anointing and with your presence. In the name of Jesus, touch each and every person that has dialed in, that has connected in with us this morning, God. God, you know every need that is in our hearts, God. You know every need that is in every home, God. And we ask, God, that you touch in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the specially designed word that you will send today for your people. God, we thank you. We praise you. We magnify you. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. We give you the highest praise, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you. We praise you, God. We lift you up, God. And as we praise, God, you're going to turn things around, God. You're going to work things out, God. And we thank you, God. You will do to us the very thing that you hear us say, God. So this morning, God, we say that you are our rock. You are our fortress. You are our God. You are Jehovah Rapha, the God that healeth us. You are Jehovah, the God that provides for us. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We cast our cares at your feet, God. And as we do, God, we thank you in advance, God, because you're going to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we think, all that we have prayed, all that we have imagined. It is so. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. We're going to sing hallelujah, salvation and glory, honor and power unto our Lord, our God. For the Lord our God, he's mighty. The Lord our God, he's omnipotent. He's all powerful. The Lord our God, he is wonderful. Won't you sing with me in your home, in the sanctuary? Oh, hallelujah. Salvation and glory. Honor and power.
Honor and power unto the Lord our God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Salvation and
salvation and glory.
Honor and
honor and power unto the Lord our God. The Lord our God
is wonderful.
He is wonderful.
For the Lord our God,
for the Lord our God,
mighty. The Lord our God,
the Lord our God, is omnipotent.
The Lord our God,
the Lord our God,
is wonderful.
He is wonderful.
Salvation and
salvation and glory,
honor
and power unto the Lord our God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Salvation
and glory,
honor
and power unto the Lord our God.
For the Lord our God is mighty.
Lord our God,
the Lord our God is omnipotent.
The Lord our God,
our God, He is wonderful.
Oh, praises be to the King of Kings and the Lord.
Wonderful, put your hands together. Hallelujah, God, you're wonderful. You're magnificent, God. There's nobody else like you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He's wonderful, hallelujah. Even in the bad times, He's wonderful. Glory to your name. We're gonna sing, Come On and Praise the Lord with me.
Come on and praise the Lord with me. Come on and praise the Lord with me. Come on and praise the Lord with me. Come on and praise the Lord with me. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and praise the Lord with me.
Praise the Lord with me.
Come on and praise the Lord with me.
Praise the Lord with me.
Come on and praise Him.
Praise the Lord with me.
Oh, praise the Lord with me. Give them the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on and clap your hands.
Clap your hands with me.
Come on and clap
your hands with me.
Put those hands together.
Clap your hands with me.
Clap those hands, clap those hands.
Clap your hands with me.
Give them the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Come on and clap those hands.
Clap your hands with me.
Put your hands together.
Your hands with me.
Let's confuse the enemy.
Your hands with me.
Clap those hands, clap those hands.
Your hands with me.
Give them the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Lord, you're worthy.
Hallelujah.
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 Come on and dance before the Lord.
Before the Lord.
Pick him up, put him down.
Dance before the Lord.
Dance before the Lord.
Before the Lord.
Dance before the Lord.
Dance before the Lord.
Give them the highest praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Lord, you're worthy.
Hallelujah.
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 Come on and dance before the Lord.
Before the Lord.
I will dance like David danced
before the Lord.
Pick them up, put them down.
Before the Lord.
Dance before the Lord.
Dance before the Lord.
Give them the highest praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lord, you're worthy.
Hallelujah.
There is no other God
hallelujah.
Like you.
Hallelujah.
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 No matter what I'm going through,
hallelujah.
Come on and tell the Lord, thank you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I will give thanks unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. Has the Lord been good to you? Hallelujah. Has he blessed you? Has he kept you? Come on and just tell the Lord, thank you. Hallelujah. And we give you the glory. Hallelujah. And we give you the honor. We give you the praise. We magnify you. We bless your name, oh God. You're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy, you're worthy. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord, and we're thankful and we're grateful to be in his presence one more time. We're thankful because the Lord has kept us. The Lord has promised, and his word is true. Amen. And amen. We magnify the name of the Lord, and God has been carrying us through a journey regarding the will of God for our lives. Amen. The will of God for our lives. Amen. And we anchor this in Genesis chapter 12 as God calls Abram. And he tells Abram, I need you to respond in faith and get thee out of the country that you are in. Amen. And in order for us to execute the will that God has for our lives, we must be people of faith. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. And then he tells Abram, I will make of thee a great nation. And we understand in order to be a nation, there are norms and there are practices and there are rules that we must follow. Amen. And God gives us his word to use as our roadmap for what the Lord will do for us. Amen. Hallelujah. And after that, he says, I will make of thee a great nation. And then he tells Abram, I will bless thee. Amen. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Amen. Hallelujah. When the Lord is doing a personal work in our lives. Amen. When the Lord blesses us. Amen. And isn't it interesting just to think that the Lord will bless us? Amen. It's one thing for your mother or your father to bless you. It's one thing for a co-worker or your supervisor to bless you. But when the Lord blesses you, amen. Hallelujah. That's not anything that anybody can take away from you when the Lord does a work in your life. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. This is Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday weekend, where we celebrate and we commemorate his life of nonviolence and the promotion of racial equality. Amen. And we certainly know we need to remember his life and legacy during such a time as this. Come on and say amen. And one of the most striking things about Dr. King is that he had a genuine love for all people. Amen. And I believe that his love for others stemmed from and was rooted in the fact that he understood that God first loved him. Amen. And when you understand that God loves you and you love God, then you can love others. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. I want to talk to you today about when we fall in love with God, it does something to us. The love that Dr. King had compelled him to action. Amen. And I believe if we are sincerely in love with God, that it will cause us to do something. It's going to move us. It's going to show up. It's going to manifest itself. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I've heard it said often that love is an action word. And on today, I want to talk to you about when we fall in love with God, it does something to us. And it causes God to respond. And when God responds, he blesses us. Let us go to the book of 2 Samuel chapter 7. Amen. We're going to go to verse number 8 and 9. And then we're going to skip ahead to verse 27. But 2 Samuel chapter 7 says, and now therefore, so shalt thou say unto my servant David, thus saith the Lord of hosts, I took thee from following the sheepcote, from following the sheep to be ruler over my people Israel. And I was with thee whithersoever thou wentest, and I have cut off all thine enemies out of thy sight, and I have made thee a great name, like unto the great men that are in the earth. And verse number 27 says, for thou, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, has revealed to thy servant, saying, I will build thee an house. Therefore hath thy servant found in his heart to pray this prayer unto thee. Amen and amen. This particular psalm is an, not psalm, but this particular scripture is an interesting scripture, because this is a passage of scripture that begins by saying that the Lord gave David rest roundabout from his enemies. Amen. Not that David was getting the upper hand, Not that the Lord was sustaining him in the presence of his enemies, but that God gave him rest from his enemies that were all around him. And what the Lord spoke to me is a word that I want to speak to you. That God is not interested in just causing you to make it. He's not interested in simply sustaining you through the challenges of life. But God is large enough and big enough and strong enough and powerful enough not only to sustain you, but to give you the victory. Hallelujah. He's strong enough to give you total victory. Victory on top of victory, surrounded by victory, double stacked with victory, and infused with victory. Hallelujah. And David has peace as he looks around himself. And he makes up in his mind that I want to do something magnificent for God. I want to honor God. I want to pay homage to God. I want to do something to magnify God's name. He's compelled because he has an immense sense of gratefulness and gratitude in his heart because of all that the Lord has done for him. And so David does the exact correct thing. The Bible tells us that he calls for Nathan the prophet. Because what David was trying to do was to validate that what I feel in my spirit is the right thing to do. Hallelujah. And so he goes to Nathan the prophet and he says, I live in a house of cedar, but the presence of God dwells in a tent. Because at this point in time, the holy place that represented the presence of God was carried from place to place. And the Ark of the Covenant dwelled within a tent. And David was saying, the Lord has blessed me. And he has established my house. And he has blessed me with a house of cedar. I want to build God a sanctuary. I want to build God a house. I want to do something spectacular, something magnificent for God. And he called Nathan the prophet because he wanted to validate that what he wanted to do was okay to do. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. Tell somebody wisdom is the principal thing. Because wisdom is not just what to do, but wisdom is when to do and how to do. Sometimes you can want to do the right thing, but it may not be the right time. And you've got to be able to synchronize what you are doing, when you are doing it, and how you are doing it to give maximum glory to God. And so David goes to Nathan the prophet. Because at that point in time, the Holy Spirit did not dwell inside of man. And so he had to validate by a prophet if what he wanted to do was okay. Hallelujah. Now we've got the Spirit of God living and dwelling on the inside of us. We don't have to go to a third party in order to hear from God. It doesn't mean that God does not use men and women of God to articulate and share his word, but we have an added benefit in that the Spirit of God can dwell on the inside of us. Come on and say thank you, Jesus. I'm so glad that God gives us access to his spirit to live on the inside of us. I'm so glad that I don't have to rely on is your cell phone on so I can get a word from the Lord. I'm so glad I don't have to worry whether or not you will decide to pick up your phone or not, whether or not I will hear from heaven, but I can go to God for myself. Hallelujah. And we find that David goes to Nathan the prophet. And he says, I want to build God a house. Nathan originally tells David, do all that is in your heart. But God summons Nathan to go back. And he says, David, I know you want to build God a house. But now is not the right time. But David wanted to bless God and honor God. David's intentions were, because God has done so much for me, I want to do something for God. Hallelujah. You've got to understand that God has brought David from a mighty long way. Hallelujah. God has protected him from danger seen and unseen. You have to remember that God has blessed him on top of blessings. And because God has blessed him so much, David feels compelled to do something magnificent for God. Because if you can remember and go all the way back to 1 Samuel chapter 17, actually chapter 16, when Jesse the prophet came to anoint the next king of Israel, he went to David's father Jesse and he said, "One of your sons is going to be the next king." And Jesse said, "Let me gather up all of my sons and present them to you so you can tell me who's going to be the next king." And Jesse gathered up all of his sons and took them over to Samuel. Samuel went to bless and figure out who the next king was going to be, and he went through each and every last son. Then he scratched his head. He says, "I know God called me. I know God told me to come to your house, but every male child that you presented before me is not going to be the next king." And Jesse scratched his head and says, "Well, I got one little boy. He's back there with the sheep. He's a nobody. We don't consider him. He's good for nothing. We just use him to clean up the animal droppings." And the man of God said, "Bring that old raggedy boy to me." And here comes David kicking off the sheep dung from his foot. Here comes David, smelly and raggedy. A little boy comes and he says, "Here I am." And the man of God says, "This is the next king of Israel, because God is no respecter of persons." Glory to God. And because God is no respecter of persons, if he can take David from the sheep coat, I'm sure that God can do something for me. Hallelujah. After the 16th chapter, David stumbles upon a giant by the name of Goliath. Goliath was stronger than him. Goliath was a man of war. Goliath had more experience than David. But what we learn from David's life, if the Lord be with you, hallelujah, he's more than the world against you. And David defeats Goliath. Come on and say, "Thank you, Jesus." And when David considers all that the Lord has done for him, he wants to do something magnificent for God. After he defeats Goliath, in the 18th chapter of 1 Samuel, he is then placed to be the ruler over all of the armed forces. And what he learned from that experience is that the Lord will make your enemies your footstool. It was his eldest brother Eliab who despised him, but now Eliab has to serve David, because God knows how to make your enemies your footstool. He knows how to prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. He knows how to give you joy unspeakable and full of glory. He knows how to give you double for your trouble. He knows how to bless you despite everything that has gone on against you. Come on and say, "Thank you, Jesus." David's time didn't get any easier, because by the 18th chapter of 1 Samuel, we find that Saul is now trying to kill David. By the 19th chapter, he's still trying to kill David, and we find that David is able to slip out of his way. Come on and say, "Thank you, Jesus." In the 23rd chapter, we find David on one side of the mountain, and we find Saul and his men on the other side of the mountain. And David would go to the left and Saul would go to the right. And Saul was not able to get to David, but he was intent on killing David. Now I need to pause for a moment, because I can sure enough identify with David. You see, it was just a little while ago when I was a young boy. I had an older brother, y'all know him as Minister Gaskin. And he did something to upset me. So I ran down the steps and his guitar
case was laying down by the door, and I stopped on his guitar case, and I opened up my eyes, and I saw my elder brother fly down the steps, and he was ready to finish me off. I ran down to Market Street. I ran all the way from 57th to 56th and Market, and my elder brother was gaining speed on me. I began to have terror in my eyes, and I knew I couldn't outrun him on a straight run, so I went behind a car and ducked down. I went to the left, and he went to the right, and I kept circling that car. He finally got frustrated, and he went on home. I don't know how long I stayed out there at 56th and Market before I went home, but I can identify with David. Thank you, Jesus, that in the time of trouble, he shall hide me. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And because David had been blessed so much by God, he wanted to do something marvelous for God. He wanted to do something spectacular for God, because David was grateful that God had brought him through. And I just wonder today if there's anybody here that's been blessed by God, that God has brought you out. By the 27th chapter of 1 Samuel, David decides, if with friends like this, I don't need enemies. And David decided to go hang out with the king of Gath. Now, if you know your Bible history, Gath is where Goliath is from. And David was saying, I'd rather hang out with my enemies than hang out with King Saul. And so he hung out with his enemies. But when he went over there to the king of Gath, they rejected him and sent him back home. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. David learned that when my mother and my father forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. But watch this, y'all. After they rejected him, he went back home to Ziklag. And when he got about a quarter of a mile away from Ziklag, he found that his town had been burnt down with fire, and that his wife was gone. And he goes home and he's distraught and he's distressed. But in his time of trouble, he calls upon the name of the Lord. And David says, Lord, shall I go up and smite the Amalekites? And the Lord said, go up, David, for you shall surely recover all. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. He went to God in prayer, went down, and he began to destroy the Amalekites. And let me explain it to you like this. David was a songster. David loved to play songs. He loved to use the musical instruments. But he heard a beautiful song, and I'm not talking about from the Book of Songs. He heard a beautiful song from the Godfather. Yes, his Godfather. You know him as Dr. James Brown. In his song called The Big Payback, he says, I don't know karate, but I sure know crazy. And David went and fought a good fight. David went and recovered all. And when the Lord blessed him to recover all, he wanted to do something special for God. Some of you are looking at me like I'm crazy. Some of you all need to go crazy. You need to go crazy on the devil. You need to say, not my family, not my money, not my child, not my situation. And I'm going to go into warfare. I'm going to fight in the arsenal of prayer. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. David had been prophesied that he would be the next king of Israel, but he had to go through all of this turmoil before it was realized. And finally, by the time we get to the second chapter, to the second book of Samuel, and the first chapter, David is finally announced that he would be the king over just Judah, all the southern tribes of Israel. So he didn't get everything. He just got two of the 12 tribes. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. I want you to know that David didn't stop when he was anointed to be king over just the two tribes, and neither should you. When God blesses you, he doesn't bless you to just have barely enough, but he wants to bless you to have more than enough. I know the debt collector isn't calling you anymore, but God wants to do more than just get you out of debt. He wants to do more than pay your rent. He wants you to own the place. He wants you to be the lender and not the borrower. Is there anybody here that knows you serve a God that's more than enough? And because God has blessed David, David wants to do something that is spectacular for God. He wants to bless God in an amazing way. And so by the time we get to the fifth chapter of 2 Samuel, he is finally anointed to be king over all of Israel. And David learned that we ought not be weary in well-doing, for in due season you will reap if you faint not. Come on and say, thank you, Lord. Now, the first thing that happened after he became king over all of Israel is that the Philistines launched an attack against him, and David learned something, and this isn't even in the scripture, but he learned, if you can't stand the heat, stay out of the kitchen. You can't want to be blessed by God and not expect to have some haters. You can't want to be blessed by God and not expect the enemy to act up. You can't want to be blessed by God and think the enemy isn't going to do anything to you. But one thing you got to know is the same God that brought you, the same God that woke you up, the same God that protected you, the same God that provided for you, is the same God that'll give you victory over the enemy. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so David gets the victory. And once he gets the victory, the first thing he does as the king is he calls for the Ark of the Covenant. You got to watch this. The Ark of the Covenant represented the presence of God. But the Ark of the Covenant had been stolen years ago. And when they got the Ark of the Covenant back, it was placed in an obscure place. It was positioned off to the side. And David says, we got to take the Ark of the Covenant and we got to make it central to all of Israel so the people can come and worship God, because it was God that protects us, God that provides for us, God that promotes us, God that places us, God that positions us, God that promises us, God that prepares us, God that prioritizes us, God that plans for us, and God that gives us peace. So get the Ark and put it as a central place of worship. And when David saw the Ark coming, he began to dance before the Lord with all of his might. He began to bless God. He began to worship God. It was in his thankfulness that he began to bless the name of the Lord. And I don't know why you're looking at me funny. I don't know why you're still quiet, but when you see what God has done for you, you ought to give him praise. You ought to give him glory. You ought to give him honor. It may take a while getting there, but I do declare, he that hath begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. It may take some time, but God's time is always the right time. It may feel like it's moving slowly, but he knows how to bring it to pass. Come on and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And so David, when he looks back over his life, and when he thinks things over, and he considers all that the Lord has done, he says, I'm compelled to do something for God. But let me give you this piece of advice. When David decides that he wants to do something for God, he puts God in a quandary, because what David was saying Lord, I'm going to bless you. What David was saying, Lord, I'm going to provide for you. What David was saying, Lord, I'm going to exalt you. And the Lord scratched his head. He had to say, wait a minute, David, how dare you think that you're going to do more for me than I do for you. I am the God of all flesh, and there's nothing too hard for me. I am the one that brought you out of the sheep coat. And in the 27th verse, he says to David, you were trying to build me a house. David, I'm going to build you a house. I'm going to bless you. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Come on and say, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord. But if you really want to be blessed by God, try blessing God. And if you bless God, God, he will bless you. Come on and say thank you. Come on and put your hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. David was compelled to do something mighty for God because of all that God had done for him. He didn't have to be forced. He didn't have to be pushed. He didn't have to be nudged. Nobody had to remind him, but he wanted to bless the Lord. And David would break out and says, oh, come magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together, because God had been so very good to him. I simply want to encourage you on today to have a grateful heart. Reflect on what the Lord has done for you. And when you begin to think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for you, I understand those of you who don't have a praise in your spirit. See, you ain't never been through nothing. You never been brought out of nothing. You never cussed nobody out. You never told a lie. But for the rest of us that's been brought through something, for the rest of us that God brought from somewhere, for the rest of us that have truly been changed, come on and say thank you. Come on and bless him. Come on and glorify him. Can nobody do me like Jesus? Can nobody do me like the Lord? Come on and bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. We magnify you. We give you the glory and the honor and the praise. We're thankful for what you've done. We're thankful for where you brought us from. We thank you for how you raised us. We thank you for how you saved us. We thank you for how you've kept us. We thank you for sustaining us. And we thank you that you're bringing us out with victory on top of victory. Victory stacked on top of victory. Victory surrounded by victory. Victory infused with victory. We thank you and we give you the glory. Hallelujah. Come on and tell them thank you. Come on and tell them thank you. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. And we bless them. Hallelujah. You might as well just thank them. You might as well praise them. You might as well glorify them. Because when the praises go up, the blessings indeed do come down. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
Do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody. Like Jesus, he's my friend. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. He's my friend.
Now listen, the Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Hallelujah. So whatever you're battling and whatever you are going through, hallelujah, we're going to pray and touch and agree right now. Those of you that are on stream, those of you that are in this house, Lord God, we thank you and we bless your name. We worship and we adore you. We magnify you and we thank you. We're grateful for what you brought us from. We're grateful for where we are right now. And we know that you did not bring us this far to leave us, but you have brought us to this place, glory to God, to bring us to our next place, to bring us to a place of victory. And for this, we want to tell you thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for all that you've done for us. Hallelujah. 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 Come on and give them thanks. Hallelujah. Come on and tell them thank you. Glory to your name, oh God. We bless you and we magnify you. Yes, Lord. We thank you for lifting us up. We thank you for pulling us out. We thank you for giving us the victory. And we magnify you and we bless your holy name. Come on and tell them thank you. Come on and clap those hands for the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Jesus. Is he all right? Is he all right? Is he all right? Hallelujah. We praise him. Hallelujah. We glorify him. We magnify him. We bless his name. We worship you for your Christ the Lord. Come on, there's breakthrough in the room. Hallelujah. Come on and tell somebody there's breakthrough in the room. Hallelujah. There's deliverance in the room. Hallelujah. There's power in the room. Come on and give him glory. Come on and magnify his name. Come on and lift him up. Come on and say yes to the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God did not allow us to come to leave the same. Hallelujah. But this is why we come, that the Spirit of God may empower and may infuse our life. We know that there is no power like his power. Thank you, Jesus. So whatever you're feeling, whatever you're going through, whatever the anxiety is, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're giving it to God right now. He says, cast your cares upon me, for he careth for us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, we give it up to you right now. Hallelujah. Won't you just do that motion? We give it up to you right now, God. We lay it all at the altar right now. All of the anxiety, all of the fear, all of the feelings of self-doubt. God, we lay it all at your feet. You alone are King of Kings. You alone are Lord of Lords. You alone are great and greatly to be praised. You alone have all power in your hands. And God, not just for us, but for our family, for our children, for our loved ones, God. We lay it all at your feet right now, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, let yokes not just be broken, but let yokes be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yea, God, let every feeling of doubt be destroyed. Let bad habits be destroyed. Yes, Lord. The devil be rebuked. Hallelujah. And victory be ours in the name of Jesus. Come on and say Jesus. Come on and say Jesus. Come on and say Jesus. That your will be done. We bind up all of the forces of darkness that weigh against us. Every trap and every ploy of the enemy, we bind it in the name of Jesus. Lord, that your power may be released and that your glory may be made manifest in our lives. And for this, we give you the glory, honor, and praise. Bless the works of our hands, God. Lord, we want to do something magnificent for you. For you first loved us. Hallelujah. And for this, we give you the glory. We give you the honor and we give you the praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We want to thank all of you that have joined us by way of stream. We want to thank God for everybody that's in the house. Hallelujah. And we give you this benediction. Hallelujah. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before his presence with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. And let us all say thank God and amen. God bless you. Thank you for being here. Amen. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord.